training and first.
And so what is on our wish list today?
Mostly me.
Yeah.
But I have, for whatever reason, even though I'm right-handed, I am weak on this side of my body. And in fact, I have a bit of a shoulder injury because just to keep him in that outside rain, it's like, it's difficult for me. So I have to compensate with my body, and particularly my shoulder blade.
Okay.
And she, in fact, I generally ride with a bowler's brace to try to keep my hand from doing this, because that's what I'll do when I can't use my arm. Exactly. So anyway, so Trish said, don't ride in your brace. Let's see what Felicity can come up with.
Let's see how we can fix it. What have been the go-to exercises that you guys been using to help him along? I mean, I can tell the right side is stiffer than the left side.
Yes. Well, I am, you know, I have scoliosis, so we work with that. But he has a lot of
somatic
modalities,
Susan,
that we use every month to hopefully
But within your daily routine of riding, what's your routine?
Listen, this is a somatics freak herself.
Rising practice. Is there something in particular you use in your daily ride that's helping him?
Well, right now the weather has been interfering hugely. We don't have an indoor.
Yeah.
But I walk him a ton and just kind of let him get relaxed mentally and physically. And we do a lot of serpentining because if we do that, he seems to just kind of come and onto the bit by himself.
Yeah,
he's a good guy, you know.
Okay.
But he's very sensitive, and if I get greedy or if I'm nervous and it's, you know, and my forearms get tight, he says, "Hell no, we're not doing this."
So we're gonna figure out a little more what we can do with the connection.
And Susan, your somatics, because Felicitas loves somatics.
You're doing somatics?
Oh, yeah. He's having Hannah somatics.
How about
equine.
You?
Not yet, but...
Hello?
I told her.
Get going. It's changed my life. I can only tell you. My riding, the quality of life. So...
Good to know. Well, yes. Mm-hmm. This is new to us. We've just discovered it. But I do love to watch the wheels turn when he... is having his
somatics. I would love
somatics.
To see your wheels turn.
Yeah.
Yours.
Yeah.
Okay. All right.
What earth is it to us?
I can help you with that too. You're here to please.
Does it cost extra? No.
Yeah, totally. That's definitely an extra 50 cents.
I had a trainer who was like, "You're not a baby." So anyway.
No, I don't like leaning over. I mean, I've had horses jump away and jump to the side. You don't need another whiplash.
Yeah.
Or come off.
Right.
And plus you hang in sideways, you're making the saddle crooked while you're tightening it, makes no sense either. So just walk him a little. Has he been here before?
Yes.
Okay.
He was here once.
Okay. Well, let him just walk around the whole perimeter once that he gets a chance to see everything, considering that horses are flight animals. Nice to allow them to see the surrounding and for yourself to breathe. What did I do with you the last time I saw you?
We worked on the taking each rein. He was completely new to this.
Yeah.
Taking each rein and just kind of inviting him.
Yeah.
And then we worked on me steering with my belly button.
Okay, good. Did I put you on the balls?
No.
Okay.
I've been on the ball of Disney,
though. Okay, good. So.
Here comes the owner of this place. She must be a multi millionaire.
So sometimes, if you have ridden with the balls, good to see you, Janet. I thought you were in Florida.
Monday.
Ah. So. If you have experienced the balls, it's always very helpful to just click into your body and feel If your seatbelts have to be like little feet that are moving all the time with the horse, and they're directing all the time. That's nice. Good job. And while you're walking, see if you can feel his front leg. Left front, right front, left front, right front, left front. Other way around, left front. Don't know my lefts and my rights.
Sorry.
Anyway, so as okay. each shoulder goes forward,
yeah.
see if you can give a little bit on that brain.
Okay.
Inside, outside. Tiny little give out of your elbow. To allow the horse to use his neck in the walk a tad more. That's part of his ability to relax. Give and give and give and give. Good job. Seat bones are moving. I was mentioning this earlier. I saw this post of a nice lady made a really nice post about stability, and she said that in riding we need dynamic stability. That means we have to move, our hips have to move, and like right here, your hands have to move a little, but your body, your upper body, your core keeps stability. Give and give. And what you find that even within this giving and giving and giving and giving, you still can ask the horse to follow or flex, just can't be rigid. And then, like you said, now he's seen the perimeter. Show me a couple of circles, show me a couple of turns.
See, I love her softness,
out of the
Felicitas.
Good.
Arms soft
and good. Legs are soft. Good job. Gently feel his ribs between your legs. Good. 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 Keep your legs lengthening and softening. Good. That's nice. Stand up for a second. So when you stand up, feel how you're up, stay standing. And now put a little weight in your heel while you're standing. There you go. And now feel your calf. How nice you're framing the horse right there between your upper lower leg. And that's where you keep connected. And now you ease back in the saddle. And you keep your legs soft and long. So alternating, they step down a little while your seat bones are moving. So you find the rhythm of the horse. You guys are gonna go together. That's the most important part. Then you can direct his energy. That's already more relaxation in the walk. Very nicely. Hands give a little, give a little. Good job. That is nice. Good. And now again, I'm gonna leave it up to you in the walk. To do a couple of turns or whatever you feel to make him follow your hand without getting tight, so you get him softly between your legs so that you can get him ready to trot. And when you feel him ready to trot, pick up a rising trot. Don't feel hurried, just get him ready in the way that you're comfortable with. Good job. Give a little, give a little. There you go. When his head goes up and you apply more pressure, the head will stay up there. Of course, his head comes down on the give. Stand in the stirrup, fork up the stride. And really far and back to rising. Feel the ball of your foot, and if you can absorb the shock in your legs. Oh. And stand again. Oh. And then back to rising. Good. And you play with it. Can I stand? Can I rise until my legs are soft? And I feel good balance over my legs. good because without balance and back to rising, good job. Now when you are standing, it's almost going to be like you're on a trampoline. You're gonna feel that bounce through your legs every stride. You go bounce, 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 but you're standing.
Susan just bought a trampoline.
Ah, that is.
Because Felicitas recommends
it. Good job.
I wonder if she's used it.
And standing again. And back to rising until you feel it. So now you can feel when you're standing, when your upper body goes too far forward, you just tip and you can't do it.
Yeah.
So take your time with the stand. Go slowly up, up, at it, and feel bounce, bounce, bounce. And back to rising. So when you do this slowly, you actually realize that it quits running away from you.
Yeah.
Because you're starting to find your balance. Good job. Because if he runs away from you, then your hand is going to resist. That's where tension. Ah, good job. And change direction. Yeah, I know. Good. Now you walk again. Good. Good job. Sue, I forgot. Have you ever skied?
No.
No.
No, I have not.
But you have run, right?
Yes.
So when you run, you feel that every stride you have to push up off your feet and walk.
We're trying.
It's okay. And good.
Okay.
Good. So stop for a second.
Mm-hmm.
So in order to go with him, you have to almost think it's a little bit more like you're on a trampoline. So when you're trying to stand, it gets clear that you are putting your legs in position, but they don't have that springy effect that they need to have to absorb the shock.
Okay.
So that's what's gonna help you to be in balance. If your leg stiffens, it doesn't absorb any shock, then your upper body just goes all over. So it's that part that helps you to find your balance. I'm gonna, because we only have 45 minutes, I'm gonna help you with this here because that's going to be really helpful.
Oh God, I bought those pants, of course.
Mm-hmm.
And I said to Trish, can I wear them? She said, if you want.
So what we have to find is a way that you can connect with them with your body, that you find your balance and then you can direct this energy. Because when he gives you a little too much, and you're bracing against it, he runs more while you run out of options, okay? So there is that idea that we have to be able to direct his energy, then it feels like the horse is in front of you. And then him going forward is not intimidating anymore, you know? So we're gonna put this over your left shoulder, and then I'm gonna put it onto your right.
Good boy. You're a good boy.
Nothing
he is good. He's good. I just
make
for sure.
Oh, she had me wear those in my lesson, and they really help.
And now you take your foot out of your stride.
They're performance bands, and they keep you connected everywhere. Your whole body. I've got them in my tent box before tomorrow.
Perfect.
So when I was describing the feelings of the leg absorbing the shock, I think about that sometimes when I walk. Every stride I take, I get an impulse up from my foot. And that's the same way I feel like when I'm riding. If I'm sitting in the shot, I get this impulse up my foot that pushes me up. You know,
and asked if
but
I could
if you
come
don't
there
come down
for the month
balls of your feet. Like if I do it on the ground, really focus on my big toe, because if I do it on my little toe, see how it kind of breaks my ankle? Mm-hmm. From here, it's hard to do. So you really have to be square, so you can do this, for example, or mm-hmm. get really light on your feet. Okay, let's walk with us and see what that buys you. Because I think the tension in your hand really just partially comes from not having control on your seat. Follow a little, you follow a little. You direct up your belly button. Legs stay soft.
What? I'll show you how they go on.
They're uneven.
And feel the elastic. The one on the right looks like it might be a little too far to the outside of your shoulder. See if you can put it a little more over. Now you come on a circle.
Am I close enough to you?
Do what?
Do you want me to come closer?
No, so wherever you feel comfortable. If you feel more comfortable closer, you can, but not necessary. Good. And then you gently take the reins shorter without getting more tension. Good. So you give a little. Good job. Feel the rhythm. Right front, left front. Good job. A little shorter the rein so your hands can stay forward, but that light. Then you stay on a 20 meter circle. Good. And now you ride a transition to a rising trot. Good. Good. And stay soft. Good. Make it a 20 meter circle, makes it a little easier.
You did say that, didn't you?
Yeah. If it gets too small, then that's even more challenge to the balance. So now you just experience what does this sling tell you, you know? Keeping your legs soft, finding the balls of your feet, and thinking you're on a trampoline. Belly button, and think about your rib cage, you know, right where this X is in front of you and behind you and on your sides. Think about the whole rib cage and think every stride you rise, you got to take that rib cage forward. It's got to stay over your legs. There you go. It almost starts to feel like your upper body gets buoyant. Light when it's over your feet. That is nice. And your hands gently push forward. Soft fingers. Lovely. Good job. And now change your rising diagonal. Good. Fingers are soft.
Arching.
Yeah. That was one stride. Good. Soften your fingers. Pushing your hands forward. There you go. And now every stride, you go a little more forward with your body, because when you're rising, the horse is not taking you forward. So if you don't use your core and your rib cage to go forward, then you're going to get left behind. Nice. And then change direction. Legs stay long and soft. Make sure your right leg starts to come down. Good job. Hands stay forward. Good. Rotate your upper body, feel the ribs. Good job. Push the hands gently forward, and now you walk. Good.
Walk, did you walk. Say? I lost my one ear.
And walk. I'm sorry. Can you still hear me or no?
Yeah.
Okay. Turn around for a second and tell me what you felt here with the sling on.
I mean, normally he's not quite so runny at home, and normally I feel like I can keep my upper body in a pretty stable position. I don't know, my friends from the barn might say or say otherwise, but so what do I feel with the sling? I guess that it's a unit.
Yeah, that's a good way of putting it.
So
did you feel like it maybe gave your legs a little bit more elasticity? Did you feel like
yes,
it?
Yes. Yeah, I do get my legs get rigid Yeah.
That's what I was thinking, you know, what he did. Did you notice what he did?
He relaxed more.
He relaxed right away.
Yeah.
So that was great. I'm gonna add a dimension to your thought process. Okay.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. So when I see you trot around either direction, there is a little trouble for you. The centrifugal forces are taking you out. Okay.
Mm-hmm.
And when we talked about this unit right here, your rib cage, the awareness of where that is really huge. Like the last time we talked about steering out of the belly button, but really what that means, the whole unit has to, for example, turn, meaning the unit from your hip up to under your armpits. That's, you know, your rib cage and just a little below are part of what have to make sure that you get into a turn, for example.
Mm-hmm.
And what you have to think, you have to be a little bit more mentally ahead that you go to where his next stride is going to be.
Mm-hmm.
So that means when you're in a turn, you deliberately have to come up and come around. Now, I want to show you something that is really hugely helpful, which is lacking for you right now, and this is not talking about the arms, okay?
Mm-hmm.
So, let's use your right arm, just because that's the one that wants to struggle with you guys. Actually, somebody hold him for a second, and I'm going to just talk to you.
He'll sit at the phone.
No, I want to be safe. I don't
okay.
have to
okay.
worry about a thing. So, that's... Let your arms hang, and now gently turn them out.
Exactly.
And feel what it does for you up top. You know, it opens you up. Now feel that you can keep this and keep your arms. They can be independent. You feel
mm-hmm.
that?
Mm-hmm.
So this is my frame. Have you ever, don't you didn't ski? Did you play an instrument?
Piano.
I mean, that does not work as well. But you still sort of have to hold your arms over here, but like if you had a violin or something, or even the flute, you got to hold your frame all more, or in ballroom dancing. But you think about this part being your frame, which allows this to be independent, okay? So from here, you can say, when I'm going to now close my hands on the reins. The first tiny little correction, huge difference is you make a little kink in your thumb, like it's a,
mm-hmm.
it's like a rooftop. It doesn't have to be so tight. Just make it.
Yeah, I have arthritis in my thumb, and that's.
Can it just relax like this? Is this painful?
It's just stiff.
Okay.
That's why I don't
okay.
tent it. Sorry.
It's okay, but just you. What you want to make sure is you don't want to engage the opposite.
Okay.
Because what it does is when you make it just a little like this,
mm-hmm.
I don't ride around like that, but I don't do this, okay?
Uh-huh.
So, and now feel, you can open the rest of the fingers, and you could hold the reins on those two fingers. That's what keeps the reins from slipping, but it allows your wrists to be soft.
Right.
Now, you can close your fingers one finger at a time, from the top down. That allows your hand to stay soft.
Okay.
If you make a fist, that starts from the little finger. So if you make a fist and you start on the bottom, you're already screwed because your
okay.
hand is tight, okay?
Yes.
So we have all the variations. Like my hand doesn't want to close the left ring finger, so I'm dropping the reins sometimes too much. But sometimes too much tension is not good either. So
no.
for you, think about closing one finger at a time so the hand can be softer.
Okay.
And this right here is where you can give, okay?
Right.
Holding your frame, but still having elasticity.
Right.
That's where I would get the give in the walk. So now, when you think about going back to your frame right here, you want to feel like, okay.
Sorry.
No, all good, you want to be in the middle. You have to gently engage your biceps to carry the hand. You don't want to do it with your lower arm. You want to do it from here. And you want to have your pecs engaged So that I couldn't, like, for example, if I push you, I shouldn't be able to push you back. Ah, do you feel how you're kind of engaged right here? So I shouldn't be able to push you forward. I shouldn't be, ah, and I shouldn't be able to push you backwards, but you want to have elasticity. So there is a sense almost like you're doing a push-up, that you're holding yourself right here. So that means when you're turned on right here and the horse goes forward, and you thinking about taking your ribs forward because you're already pushing forward,
mm-hmm.
it's gonna be much easier to go up and forward and come around than when you're kind of in limbo here, because then you have to do it all from here.
Right.
If you do it from here, it's like you imagine you're on a train and a train takes off. If you can find this engagement up here and you're standing, it's much easier to hold your balance. So if you can think about this upper part, like, Lori, can I change my armpits and carry my hands from here and keep this part soft? Can that also help you with your balance? Because there's a whole connection here.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
Okay, that's what we're gonna try.
Thank
See if
you.
That works.
Yeah,
where were you?
Oh.
Down the road.
This was
you know what? It's so much fun at any time. You know, if you stop learning, then it's not anything. And some of these discoveries I just made myself to explain it that way, feel it that way, where it comes from, you know? I've learned a lot from my sister and my cousin. Steal from everybody I can steal from. I give them both, and I mean, give them credit. But, so now you feel like, can you have your armpits engaged? There, you take your veins a little shorter. Love the arms are already super soft. I love that. Good job. Yeah. Good. That gently feeling I'm pushing forward. There. Be engaged. Your armpits, your upper arm. You're carrying your hands from your upper arm. And then you take the veins a little shorter because we're going to trot again. And in the trot, again, mentally, you have to think about in the rising trot, I gotta rise to where I want the next stride to be. Good. So whenever you're ready, do this is a trot. Good, you push your arms to where you wanna be, out of your armpits. So that means you gotta take your core with you, your ribs with you, push your hands forward with your upper arm. Pushing off your left leg to come around to bring your knee. Ah, nice. And the hands push forward out of your armpits. The fingers close from the top down so they're soft. Good job. So the wrist can relax. Soften your right leg. Good job. There you go. Your armpits are working. They're pushing you forward. They're bringing your hips around. Yep. And your upper arm pushes forward. There, the hands are soft. Good job. Upper arm pushes forward. Good job. Yeah, good. And you can take the vein a tiny little bit shorter and feel like you're pushing your hands more towards his withers. There. Yeah, out of your armpits. Your left armpit could do a little more.
Pushing.
No, I'm sorry. Your right armpit could do a little bit more pushing. And your left armpit, that comes around. Ah, there you go. Good job. And now you change your knee. Super, the fingers are soft. One finger at a time. Good. Good. Next time around, you change direction. Feel your knees and your ankle on the right leg. Got to keep your legs soft.
Oops.
Okay, that was a little driver's error. Good job. Anyway, give yourself more space. It's such a beautiful arena. Good job. Your hands stay pushed forward. Good job. Out of the armpits. Yeah. And now is your outside armpit coming along? Your right armpit got to rotate and turn. There you go. There you go. Push the hand forward. You can always take the vein shorter if you push your hand forward and you run out of room. Almost like you want to push your left pinky and your right pinky towards the horse's mouth. Push the hands. Yeah. Keep your rising, every stride, you go to where you want to go. You can't stop the movement. Good job, good job. In case you want to take your energy to the next stride, and you push that little finger forward so you're lengthening the bottom of your hand. One finger at a time, take the hand. Good man, take the knees a little further. Good job, and the hands stay forward. Good. Your armpits, take your ribs more forward and around. There has to be a lot more dynamic for you to go to the next stride. Good job. Push your hand forward. There you go. You're bouncing him forward. Help him out. More momentum is helpful. Good. Outside hand got to go forward. You got to give him room to come around the turn. Give. Good job. Give. Push the hand. There you go. And take your body with you. Push with your upper arm and take your ribs with you. Your whole rib cage got to push forward. You got to go to that next stride. And you've got to embrace the swing. Embrace his flow. Good job. Good job. Good. How's this counter been?
Good. It's
okay,
forward.
So let's go ahead and pick up a counter to the left then. Same feeling. Legs stay long. Hands push forward. Legs down. Good job. Doesn't matter. Good. Balance. Go with him. Go with him. Every stride. There you go. Hands off. Push the hands forward. Wrist stays soft. And then you can't do it again. And you have to feel that you're gliding to the next stride. Take your time. Good. Give a little on that right rein. Go outside rein, outside hand forward. Good. Hands forward. And say yes to canter, not no. Sit, sit. Good job. Perfect. Good. Push your hands forward. Say yes to canter. Good job. Outside leg back. Good. Outside leg back. Say yes to cantering. Push your hands forward. There you go. And now you take a long breath out and you try it. Good job. Yeah, good job. Good. Push your hands forward. Give. Less pressure in your hand. Give. Am I balanced? You got to be able to make a slack in the range of motion. There you go. Good job. There you go. Nicely done. A little slack in the range. Good. And change direction. Good for you, Sue. Nice.
I mean, she wants her to use the whole ring, but she's making them open.
Hands forward.
Yeah.
Go with him. Rotate. Hands forward. Good job. Good job. So if you want to slow his tempo,
yes,
it would be your outside rein on the up. Give me the. So there you go.
There you go.
That's the only time you can slow him down is here. Here, but you gotta lighten, because if you're already pulling, then you can't slow him down.
Mm-hmm.
Good, little tickle on the outside rein on the rise. There, left ring finger. That is nice. Good job. Then your body comes around, then forward, and the inside rein gives. Beautiful, push out of your armpit. Rear outside rein in the, on the up, only on the up. If you hold, he's gonna grab the bit and go.
Yes, right.
Which you already demonstrated. So you got to give again on the left. So you can catch him on the up. You can slow him. It's rhythmical. Everything is rhythmical. And give. Good job. And light. The lighter it is, the easier this whole thing is. It's easier to find your balance. It's hard to find your balance against 50 pounds in your hands. Good. It's also your indicator of your balance. Plus, if you have only 10 grams in your hand, good. That is nice. Good job. And light. Push the hand out of your armpits. Your core is engaged. Your ribs come around. Your fingers soften. And the outside finger can close on the up. That is nice. And then your right leg can gently push your belly out a little bit. Bending. Stay pushed forward. Good job. That is nice. There you go. Soften the fingers.
My battery's low, so it's up to you.
Nicely done.
I'm going to see how far I get.
There. Now you go forward to walk. Little tuck on the outside rein on the up. Ribs quickly and go. And now you let them stretch. Okay. What did you feel here?
Have been kind of taught to like hold the outside rein with the like death grip.
Yeah.
And that's how I keep him from running away with me.